Recording, inquiry, matter, Captain Kirk, James T. Subject, circumstances of death, Lieutenant Commander Finney, Benjamin.
This inquiry to determine whether a general court-martial should be convened against Captain Kirk on charges of perjury and culpable negligence.
Ready.
Let's begin with your relationship with Commander Finney. You knew him for a long time, didn't you?
Yes, he was an instructor at the academy when I was a midshipman, but that didn't stand in the way of our beginning a close friendship. His daughter, Jamie, who was here last night, was named after me.
It's common knowledge that something happened to your friendship.
It's no secret. We were assigned to the same ship some years later. I relieved him on watch once and found a circuit open to the atomic matter piles that should have been closed. Another 5 minutes could have blown up the ship.
Ship, nomenclature, specify.
The United Starship Republic, number 1371.
Continue.
I closed the switch and logged the incident. He drew a reprimand and was sent to the bottom of the promotion list.
And he blamed you for that?
Yes. He had been at the academy for an unusually long time as an instructor. As a result, he was late in being assigned to a starship. The delay, he felt, looked bad on his record. My action, he believed, made things worse.
Comment. Service record of Lieutenant Commander Finney to be appended this inquiry.
Noted.
Now let's get into the specifics of the storm, Captain.
Weather scan indicated an ion storm dead ahead. I sent Finney into the pod.
Why Finney?
His name was at the top of the duty roster.
If he blamed you...
He may have blamed me that he never rose to command a ship, but I don't assign jobs on the basis of who blames me. It was Finney's turn, and I assigned him. He had just checked in with me from the pod when we hit the leading edge of the storm. Not too bad at first. I signaled a yellow alert. Then we began encountering pressure, variant, stress, force 7, the works. I finally signaled a red alert. Finney knew he had a matter of seconds. I gave him those seconds and more. But apparently it wasn't enough.
Then why, Captain, does the computer log from your ship, made automatically at the time, indicate that you were still on yellow alert when you jettisoned and not on red?
I don't know. There's been a mistake.
It would seem so. Could the computer be wrong?
Mr. Spark is running a survey right now, but the odds are next to impossible.
Stop recording. Now look, Jim. Not one man in a million could do what you and I have done. Command a starship. 100 decisions a day, hundreds of lives, staked on you making every one of them right. You played out, Jim. Exhausted.
Is that the way you see it?
That's the way my report will read if you cooperate.
Physical breakdown, possibly even mental collapse.
Possibly.
I'd be admitting that a man died because...
Admit nothing. Say nothing. Let me bury the matter here now. No starship captain has ever stood trial before, and I don't want you to be the first.
But if what you suspect is true, then I'm guilty. I should be punished.
I'm thinking of this service. I won't have it smeared.
By what? Commodore Stone.
All right. By an evident perjurer who is either covering up his bad judgment, his cowardice, or something...
That's as far as you go, sir. I'm telling you I was there, on the bridge. I know what happened. I know what I did.
It's in the transcript. And computer transcripts don't lie. Now, I'm telling you, Captain, either you accept a permanent ground assignment or... the whole disciplinary weight of Starfleet Command is going to light right on your neck.
So that's the way we do it now. Sweep it under the rug and me along with it. Not in your life. I intend to fight.
Then you draw a general court.
Draw it? I demand it. And right now, Commodore Stone, right now.